Hallo allemaal en leuk dat je kijkt naar weer een gloednieuwe vlog van mij. Hier op It's All Tracks, de enige echte natuurlijk. Er zijn weer twee nieuwe video's van Planet Coaster 2. En ik wil even de beelden laten zien hoe dat eruit komt te zien. We gaan even kijken en dan gaan we weer onze ongezouten mening geven. Nou ja, ongezouten mening. Ik ben gewoon zo lyrisch over dit spel. Dit spel kan gewoon niet kapot. Ik kan hier echt geen ene kritische noot opgeven. Het is gewoon fantastisch. Maar goed, we gaan even kijken. Wow. Fantastisch. Super. Deep dive. Coasters en waterparks.
I'm Rick Neubold, game director. And I'm Adam Wood, senior executive producer. And we are really excited to show you the very first look at Planet Coaster 2 in this first deep dive video. We're going to take a look at the combination
video
of water parks and roller coasters.
Whoa.
So let's dive in.
Mooi dat zwemmen, hè?
What is Planet Coaster 2?
Planet Coaster 2 is the sequel to the original Planet Coaster, the game we'll know and love. It's a creative management sim about building and designing those amazing theme parks.
Fantastisch, hey.
A successful park, making sure your guests are happy and spending money so you can keep building it and expanding it. And it's about sharing
fantastisch
those
build,
well.
Eh?
And in Planet Coaster 2, we're bringing those amazing water parks that have been requested by our community for many years now into a game that you know and love.
Speaking of water parks, we are here already in the water park area
development
of this
build.
Theme park that we built already.
Zo ziet het spel
this
er dus uit.
This is a work in progress sandbox from one of our development builds. But you can see our guests are already
kijk
enjoying
eens
the pool that I've placed here.
Allemaal aan het zwemmen.
Down quite quickly using the new pool tool where you can place geometric shapes or custom shapes as well. Kind of building to your heart's content, really.
Whoa.
In the back we have body flumes. These are constructed piece by piece just like the roller coaster tracks you can see in the far distance as well.
Oké, de glijbanen, dat zijn dus allemaal kleine deeltjes. Net als zoals je zeg maar de achtbanen bouwt in Planet Coaster 1. Dus je kan zelf kan je eigen, achtbanen in elkaar zetten. De vorm ervan kan je zelf dus helemaal beheren. Wat ik ook hoorde was dat vormen van het zwembad, als het goed is, die kan je dus zelf maken, zoals je zelf wilt.
Allow me full creativity. I choose exactly how I want.
Leuk trouwens dat boompje hier, hè, aan de linkerkant.
On that slide to look and to work. I do have to balance, of course, excitement, fear and nausea. Right? We don't want to overexcite our guests, or maybe they do. Guests will have certain preferences and tolerances to that. We also have the rather incredible looking drop piece at the top.
Ja,
here.
Dat is die dive glijbaan. Fantastisch.
Come shooting down the slide.
Kijk eens hoe druk het daar is.
The splashport at the end there. We get a good view from that point, I think. There we go. What you got on that?
That is not the kind of ride that appeals to me. I get motion sick and I'm afraid of heights. So neither of those things have made this flume appealing.
I will
also
notice
that we have the ability to have transparent sections.
Oké, je kan dus ook transparante stukken erin zetten.
Kind of inspired by real life flumes and real life water parks. And you can, as you clearly can see here, you can also change the colors.
Je kan ook dus de kleuren van de glijbaan kan je dus ook aanpassen.
Bringing water to Planet Coaster 2 has been really exciting. It's been great. It's been a challenge as well of how we provide tools for players to create those kind of authentic looking pools of water that you see in water parks. Those kind of, sometimes they're geometric shape, they're kind of square or rectangular, or they have these kind of natural kidney bean shapes as well, making sure we have tools that allow players to build those kind of pools in their water parks. It's also how they look, and we want to make them look very visually appealing for our guests. We wanted an aesthetic
ook menu is
kind
een beetje vernieuwd.
Vibrant blue water that you see in that idealistic water park
pools,
that we all have in our
facility,
minds as well.
Stuff,
and making
scenery.
Sure that it looks amazing
ook een beetje
and interacts
veranderd,
well with your guests, whether it's on a flume or as they're jumping into from the side as they're cannonballing and things like that. So it's been great bringing that through development from a kind of basic prototype to something that looks visually amazing as well.
I think it was also an interesting point to think about the management element of what a water park needs. You know, we have the new lifeguard, the new staff type, right, which has its safety.
Wow.
Safety-conscious.
Je hebt dus ook een lifeguard.
Een
zwembad. Noem je dat? Een badmeester.
Lifeguard. I think they're out currently making sure someone's not panicking too much in the water. And there's also the economy side of the water park and how that helps me expand my park even further. We have guest services, which are the areas where you'll buy the pool passes now, so I can monetize access
new
to the pools
winkles
and, you know, keep
for
my
swim
economy going. We've got a new shop, Splash Emporium, buying all those inflatables ready to use in the pool as well.
Always need those for a pool, and as you say, there's the economy aspect as well, making sure you've got the price point for those things right, so that they're appealing to your guests, but also high enough so that you can kind of make as much profit as possible. keep your park economy going.
Some would say the most important part of a water park would be its changing facilities.
I would say
kleedkamers
and the pools are the most important part.
I
think you're right.
Die zien er dus zo uit.
They are. And they,
ja,
they
een beetje hetzelfde als een staf building en een wc.
Changing rooms,
zo zien ze er een beetje uit.
And of course get changed back into their clothes, ready if they want to enjoy the rest of the park.
One of the important parts of your park are your guests. They're the whole point that we're building these big parks, to keep them entertained, keep them spending money, and give them a really thrilling time. In Planet Coaster 2, we've taken the opportunity to rebuild the guests, the kind of the way they look, providing a lot more diversity, representation, and variety in the guests that are in your parks. They're also going to have more feedback into whether they're having a good time or a bad time. And we've also got them being affected by kind of bigger things in the park as well, such as the weather. The water parks, giving us an opportunity to have these wonderfully hot, vibrant parks. And in Planet Coaster 2, they'll be a bit affected by things like sunburn. So you've got to make sure that they...
Oh, mensen kunnen dus ook in de zon verbranden. Dus moet je dus zonnebrandcreme winkeltjes maken waar ze de zonnebrandcreme kopen. Want anders verbranden ze dreigen. Wauw.
They have access to sun cream to make sure that they don't get burned or they've got enough cover from the bright sun.
So this lady's got some factor 50 on.
I hope so as well. So, yeah, they'll also give you that feedback of there being on a ride that's too thrilling or fearful or too nauseating as well. So you'll have that more immediate feedback from the guests themselves onto what kind of time they're having in the park, whether it's a good one or a bad one.
And it's not just guests
super
that
we've
sort of gone back and looked at refreshing and rebuilding. We've also taken the firm fan favourites of flat rise and coasters over to Planet Coaster 2, but we've rebuilt them, really. You know, we've rebuilt them ready for more creative options. You'll see here we've got our teacups, but they look quite wildly different now. This has had a bit of a pass from me on its queue path and on attaching scenery directly to rides now and blueprints to directly arrive to rides.
Really quick and easy. Helemaal aangepast, helemaal.
Put it to any of the parts.
Komt natuurlijk ook al in Planet Coaster 1.
Because although this year the park's using one of our new themes, an aquatic theme, the teacup itself looks like it's aquatic themed as well, but that's not because it's an aquatic teacup. We built the teacup to be planar in this case, to allow us to put the aquatic scenery directly onto the ride. So
Some of the
rides from Planet Coaster 1.
Wow. Je kan dus de theekopjes attracties kan je dus ook zelf aanpassen. Dus de schijf daarop, net zoals dat gele ding wat je ziet, is een soort, wat is het? Zo'n soort duikbootachtig dingetje is het. Die kan je dus zelf opzetten en die blijft dus ook staan. Dus als je een attractie hebt, bijvoorbeeld de theekopjes, dan kan je dus dingen erop maken. Kan je dingen erop maken en dan blijven ze ook staan. Super gaaf. Zo kan je dus altijd een theekopjes attractie of een andere flat ride. Kan je dus aanpassen en dan is het dus altijd. Ja, ziet het niet hetzelfde uit, maar altijd kan je het zelf naar je eigen maatstaven kan je het aanpassen. Wauw.
The original one that we've rebuilt have been kind of paired back to allow us to put those scenery pieces on.
Yeah, to allow you guys more freedom in how you want to theme it.
Yeah, exactly.
It means that you have a lot more options now. Echt helemaal thematiseren naar je eigen hand zetten.
Anywhere in my park, any theme in my park, how do I do that? Well, now I've got more flexibility in putting scenery, putting blueprints on, and having it animate and move around with the ride itself, which is
zie je, het gaat dus met de attractie mee. Dus als je iets op de attractie zet, draait het mee.
Blueprint in the middle of the pedestal.
And I'm sure many eagle-eyed viewers will have noticed that there's patterns on this ride as well. That's another customized option. All rides will come with predefined patterns. You can select it and then it will appear on certain parts of the frame and the teacups as well here. We have the 360 power, another returning favourite in the back as well. You can see another example of how we've used other parts of the aquatic theme to change the look and feel of this ride completely. And
see,
it's only
je kan dus echt naar je eigen dingen aanpassen helemaal, hoe het er zelf uit komt te zien.
Allemaal
extra dingetjes erop zetten en zo. En het blijft dus ook gewoon zitten, dat het dus met de attractie dan meedraait.
And another little example of how the just one theme can look so radically different using different colors and different color palettes and ways between the two here. I suppose I've teased a little bit of what's around.
Fantastisch.
Yeah, we can see it over there. Keep moving the camera around to get us all excited about it.
Yes, it's not just standard body blooms that are going to come brand new to Planet Coaster 2.
Kijk eens, wat een mooie glijbaan.
We're also looking at other varieties as well, such as
dat is zo'n glijbaan die
hele looking.
Ja, dat je dus
up to six
person. Kijk, dus van de ene kant naar de andere kant.
Completely inspired by real life pieces.
Dit is echt gaaf.
I would definitely go on this. I think I would grade this one, actually. As well as that, we have the plug hole here in the middle. We've got the sphere, and we have the boomerang nestled in the back as well. All inspired by real-life water rides in real life. And the other thing you'll notice, quite strikingly, is that the colour and the patterns on these ones are very different to what we had at the beginning. New customization options to the new rides in Planet Coaster 2 means I can very quickly create these stripes if I so wish to, which gives a real
fantastisch
visual panache.
It looks lovely. Really does.
Looked at the vijfje
different flumes
on the linkerkant.
And we have different special pieces for those as well. We don't just have these ones.
Fantastisch.
Pieces one of many. Absolutely.
Yeah.
But it isn't just flat rides we can customize in Planet Coaster 2.
Whoa.
I can now also add my personal
touch to any of the coaster cards. Dit is echt heel gaaf. Je kan dus ook achtbanen kan je dus aanpassen. Dat deze ronde, wat is het eigenlijk, zeg maar? Een soort rondje, zo'n renningsboei, hebben ze dus op deze achtbaan geplakt. En die blijft dus ook zitten. Fantastisch.
I've got my Whirlpool coaster at the back here. It's closed, ready for the guests to get onto, because I was just adding some scenery pieces to it here. It's got an aquatic theme, so I thought I'd add a ring to the front, as if it's kind of been constructed or come straight from the factory like that. And we've also got these really lovely light bars from the resort theme, which is one of the other new things coming to Planet Coaster 2. I'll just pop them on the side. And although I do still have all of the advanced object movement tools that we are used to in Planet Coaster, the original one, I didn't actually have to hand place all of these lights down the side. We have very clever tools where I can mirror from this side.
Die lichtjes hebben ze dus ook aangepast.
I can also do twinning, which means it will apply to all of the cars in my train, but I can also then make it affect all trains.
Dus je kan dus zeg maar dingen plaatsen. En dan kan je dus zeggen van ik wil dat erop hebben, maar ik wil dat ook op de andere karretjes hebben. Dus als je dan hier een lampje plaatst, dan gaat hij dus bij de andere, zet hij er dus ook automatisch een lampje op. Wauw, super gaaf.
And that's why in the background you also see that the second train has been customized.
Je kan dus het op de ene attractie kan je het zetten. Op de ene achtbaantrein kan je het zetten. En dan op de volgende achtbaantrein, daar wordt het dus ook dan op geplaatst. Super gaaf.
I placed all of them down. I placed that one ring and I placed that one light bar. Set the right options and it appears everywhere else.
It's going to be great to see how people in our wonderful community can bring those scenery pieces and blue
pieces.
Yours is very
subdued or subtle.
It is incredible.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks for the time you had to get it.
Zeker.
But with time and imagination, I know the community are going to really put together the scenery pieces, the ability to change the color, to change the scale of objects now as well, attach them to rides, to coaster cars.
Yeah, we haven't even spoken about scaling.
Yeah. To come up with so many wonderful creations. I'm really looking forward to that. And it's not just favorite rides and fan favorite coasters. We have such a big suite of rides and coasters. We also have new ones as well, such as this Frenzy Thrill ride, which is going to spin our guests on in a terrifying way. In my opinion,
I wouldn't go.
I think they're excited.
Really? I wouldn't. I am a roller coaster and water ride guy. Flat rides sometimes. My belly's a bit too old these days. I feel a bit sick. The nausea rating on this one probably a bit too high for me. But yeah, it'll be a good roller coaster and I'm all right.
Wow.
For what it's worth, this is one of my favourite rides in the game. Me too. I would never go on it in real life, but I love the way it looks. I love the way it moves. I'm really excited to add it to Planet Coaster 2.
We've had a look at some of the creative tools coming, and I touched on some of the new management features with the facilities and the new shop earlier. But we've got some new ones. We've got other ones, haven't we?
Ooh. Yeah, as part of the water parks, we have water filtration. So you need to make sure that these pools that are being used by our guests stay nice and clean.
Wow, je moet dus filters bouwen, een soort motor bouwen, filter bouwen in je zwembad, zodat je zwembad schoon blijft. Wow.
Over time, as the pools get busier and busier, they're going to get dirtier and dirtier. So you need to make sure you have a water filtration system in.
Als er steeds meer mensen in zitten, dan wordt het zwembad ook vuil. Dan wordt het water vuil. Dus dan moet je echt een machine neerzetten, zodat die het water zuivert en het zwembad schoon blijft.
Place for your pools and your flumes. And then on your coasters, your rides and your facilities, we have a power system as well. So you need to make sure there's enough power for them to keep running and for your guests to use them.
Wow. Ook dus met achtbanen is het zo dat als je dus een achtbaan hebt, een soort pauzestation moet je erbij zetten, zodat de achtbaan genoeg stroom krijgt. Wauw.
En they'll need maintenance.
Super gaaf.
Exactly. You need to make sure you've got that spine, that essential part of running a park is the staff. So making sure you have all of the appropriate staff in place, enough of them as well. Make sure they're happy, paid well.
Je moet dus genoeg staf neerzetten.
Your power and your water need to have mechanics. As to your rides, make sure
mechanics heb je daarvoor nodig.
And repaired if they break down.
Wow.
We've seen our lifeguards in action in our pool already. This park needs more janitors.
I was about to say.
It's a very dirty park.
Sure, you, dus ook,
you need janitors
neerzetten.
Perhaps I need to hire
schoonmakers.
Yeah, exactly. We need to make sure
ze maken er anders een puin op van.
So the janitors to clean your park, make sure guests are enjoying a nice clean park. No one wants to be
full of litter. Super gaaf.
Vendors for your shops.
Vendors voor je winkels natuurlijk, net zoals Planet Coaster 1.
That's souvenirs. We have ride attendants. Make sure that your rides and your coasters and your flumes stay open so that your guests can keep on using them. And we have a wonderful
dus ook, voor mijn menu, dus ook aparte mensen aannemen die dus de achtbaan draaien. Ja, dat is gaaf.
Queen Splash.
Queen Splash.
King Splash.
We've been enjoying this
Queen Splash.
Deep dive in our more traditional camera view, but wow. I think we should enjoy that coaster you've been customizing. I think we can enjoy that first person and kind of really see what the guests are going to feel as well as they go around your park.
Of course, it's not just your roller coasters you'll be able to experience in first person mode. You'll be able to experience all of your flat rides and also your water plumes as well, including that very impressive looking raft plume we saw earlier. I can imagine going down that fly trap in the hot seat.
Super gaaf.
In this deep dive, we've just been giving you an overview of what's going to be possible in Planet Coaster 2, bringing those amazing water park visuals
super
to the game.
Gaaf.
Those, as you say, there's amazing flumes and slides in their pieces. We've got our new creative tools. We have new themes and the ability to customize those rides and those coaster cars as well.
Super gaaf.
Next up, we'll have a look at the tools that you'll be using to create these parks. We can't wait to show you more. Thank you so much for watching.
Binnenkort gaan ze weer meer laten zien. Super gaaf. Create a splash. Wishlist nou, planetcoaster.com. Ja, super gaaf jongens, super gaaf. Ja, dat zag er echt super gaaf uit. Ik heb nog een video, die laat ik binnenkort even zien aan jullie. Maar het ziet er nu al super gaaf ziet het er nu uit. Ik bedank jullie allemaal voor het kijken. Dit was de vlog voor vandaag. Ik bedank jullie voor het kijken. Ik zou zeggen jongens, vonden jullie deze vlog leuk? Doe een duimpje omhoog. Abonneer op mijn kanaal voor meer. Druk op het belletje, dan worden jullie op de hoogte gehouden als er weer een nieuwe video of livestream is. En als je abonneert, vergeet het belletje niet voor de notificaties. De groetjes van deze kant en jongens, tot de volgende vlog maar weer. Bye bye. Hoi.